case study on cholesterol from the Kahn Center for Cardiac Longevity. This is Joel Kahn, MD. You're looking at a CT scan slice from a heart. The yellow arrow is pointing at the heavy calcification in the widowmaker, the left main and left anterior descending artery. There are lungs, there are bones that are bright white and ribs and such, but that's not what you want. So how does that help? I saw a woman this week, it's interesting. 6 years ago in her early 50s, she had some chest pain at her mother's funeral, and 5 days later had more chest pain, went to the emergency room. They did a catheterization and they told her she had an unusual condition called SCAD, S-C-A-D, spontaneous coronary artery dissection. Looks like the artery's torn a bit, like we can do with a balloon when we're doing angioplasty, but there was no balloon. It was spontaneous. It had closed the little vessel. She didn't need a stent. She was told she had a minor heart attack. She was a heart patient. Well, she saw a cardiologist and was urged to be on cholesterol medicine and aspirin and all the rest. About 2 years ago, she came to see me for a second opinion, and we did a review of that catheterization film. It didn't look to me like this female-targeted SCAD syndrome, very common in women during pregnancy, not common, but that's the group, those that may be on oral contraceptives. It didn't look like atherosclerosis. I thought it might have been a little spasm, which severe stress can bring on, called the stress cardiomyopathy. At any rate, at that time, her cholesterol was 170, her LDL was 90, her HDL was 80. Pretty good numbers. She didn't want to be on a statin, and those were numbers on a plant whole food diet. Well, in the year since I've seen her, she developed an H. pylori issue in her stomach, was told for an anemia, go back eating eggs, go back eating red meat. So she had labs done about 2 weeks ago, and her total cholesterol wasn't 170, it was 240. And her LDL wasn't under 100, it was now up in the 140, 150 range. Her local cardiologist said, here's your statin. You have on the chart that you had a heart attack. You have on the chart, you have some kind of coronary syndrome, SCAD. So we were able to get this done right before a lockdown briefly, but she went for a coronary artery calcium scan. I just showed you a very scary one. Hers came back perfectly zero. Now she's in her late 50s. A zero in your late 50s is quite good. It doesn't guarantee you'll never have heart disease of the atherosclerotic kind, but it's very good news. And we discussed all this, and the question is, she would have been put on a statin in almost every cardiology office in the United States, but really she didn't have an atherosclerotic event. In fact, we've also done a CIMT last year, perfectly clean carotid arteries. Do you use a statin when your arteries are perfectly clean? Well, now the American Heart Association, the American College of Cardiology, the European Society of Cardiology, all in 2019 said, probably not. Let's try lifestyle, lifestyle, lifestyle. So we didn't use a statin. She's gonna drop the eggs. She wants to have egg whites. I'm not gonna yell at her, but drop the egg yolks. Get rid of the red meat, put in tempeh, put in beans, put in whole grains. Let's get back to the diet you were on. It's not really an appropriate H. pylori diet to add in animal products, and she's past that anyways. And let's see where her numbers are in about 2 months. Plenty of natural agents if we really wanted to. Bergamot, an Italian citrus root, amazing to lower cholesterol safely with essentially no side effects. Berberine, another plant-derived product that comes from barberries, amazing if needed. Of course, there's red yeast rice and niacin. I urge her to eat some organic tofu and oat bran and oatmeal and maybe a couple of Brazil nuts a week and all the things and tricks that can lower cholesterol. Ground flaxseed, 2 tablespoons a day is a natural way to lower cholesterol. Exercise, whole food plant diets. So interesting case study how the coronary artery calcium score, despite her history on the chart of a cardiac event, which probably was grief-induced coronary spasm, and she's past that, was able to help us define how low risk she was and that she didn't need a prescription drug for the rest of her life. That's what we do at the Kahn Center for Cardiac Longevity, case study of the week.